Welcome to Modern Architectures. My name is Jesper Scherpenhauser, and today I want to talk about Colfax RPA running in Docker containers. And before we actually dive into that topic, let me just quickly introduce this new series. I've been thinking about doing something like this for quite some time, where I want to create a series of videos where we're going to talk about new and modern architectural principles, like, for instance, containerization. That's why we are talking about Docker, things like scalability and elasticity. So we want to bring Kubernetes into the mix, but also the whole principle behind the cloud of choice. So how do we then take all of these technologies and deploy them either in a public cloud, in a private cloud, in a hybrid cloud, for instance? How do we make sure that we can have all of these great building blocks that make up the Colfax Intelligent Automation Platform, and how we can then make them land wherever organizations need them? So first, let's talk about Docker, right? Docker has been around for a couple of years. I think the first release was in 2013, if I'm not mistaken, and it has had a tremendous impact on how organizations deploy solutions, how they deploy, well, services, you name it. And there is a lot of great content out there that talks a bit more about the history and the philosophy and how Docker actually works. And I don't want to summarize that in this video, but feel free to pause this video and do some research and then come back here once you've done that. But in a nutshell, what Docker actually is, it's that logical evolution of virtualization, where instead of having a virtual machine that also has the operating system in there, in a Docker container, you can still share the operating system of the actual host and have access to the kernel there as well. And then you also have that whole notion of containers. So if you imagine a shipping container, you'll see that, well, even though these are all containers coming from different companies, different logistics companies, but they all fit together on a single ship. And the main reason for that is, of course, that the dimensions of these containers is uniform and it's been standardized. So they can fit on ships, on trains, on trucks, you name it, because they all adhere to that same standard. And that's exactly the same thing that's happened here. So I can build my container on my virtual machine and then deploy that and follow the life cycle that I envision there. And I don't have to worry on where it's going to land and if it's going to be able to run there, because I know it's a container, it's a standardized interface, it will work. So if you then have a look at Colfax, so historically, Colfax has supported Docker for two main components of the Intelligent Automation Platform, being Colfax SignDoc and Colfax RPA, and we're going to focus on RPA in the rest of this video, of course, but all of the other components within the Colfax Intelligent Automation Platform will be Dockerized, and we are already there with, for instance, a Colfax Communication Manager and Total Agility, the flagship product, of course. So that being said, let's have a look at how we can actually create RPA containers and how we can then deploy them and how we can then design a nice architecture. Well, this is what you need if you want to follow along. First off, you'll need to get your hands on Colfax RPA for Linux and a valid license. And I'm going to show you how you can get a hold of those. You'll need to have Docker Desktop installed. I'm going to do this from my Windows laptop, but if you're running on a Mac, you can follow along, but you will need to make some tweaks here or there. You'll need to have a PowerShell enabled terminal. I like the Windows terminal. That's a tool you can download from the Microsoft Store. And you'll need to have a good text editor. Notepad will work, but I will always recommend either to use Visual Studio Code, Notepad++, or your text editor of choice. Doesn't really matter. So the first thing we need is we need to have a license and we need to have access to Colfax RPA. So if you go to the colfax.com website and you go to the RPA product, you'll have the option there to get a free trial, a license for Colfax RPA. So I'm just going to do that together with you, and I'm just going to fill out my information here. And I'm still working for Colfax, yeah. jesper.schepenhuizen at kofax.com. So if you have any questions, please drop me a line on that email address, right? My business phone is, I'm not going to put that there. I'm in the Netherlands, and my job title is Senior Sales Engineer. And I'm in sales, apparently. Yes, within 3 months. May keep me informed. Yeah, you can do that. So once you do this, it'll take a couple of minutes for the processes and the robots actually running on the back end to ship a license to you. You'll get that in your email inbox. And what you can then do is you can already start to download it from that email, but because we want to get our hands on the Linux version, I would recommend against doing that straight away. So we're just going to wait for the email to come in. There we have it. So you will then get an email that looks something like this. So you have your licenses in the zip file there, and it's going to tell you where to download. So because we want to get our hands on the Kofax RPA for Linux package, I would say don't click that link in the email, because that will lead you to the Windows installers. But let's just go for delivery.kofax.com. I'll put all the links in the description below. So I'm going to create a new account there, and I'm going to use this one, and I'm going to put an exclamation mark there. There we go. So we now have a new account on delivery.kofax.com, and you can then fill out all of these things if you want. You will need to activate this, of course, so you need to click that link. I've done that in a different screen for now. Once that's done, just refresh this, and you can actually register your new serial number right there by adding software. So you go back to your email, you grab your serial number. Here you go. Put that in. Remove the space. That's very important. There you go. And now you see that you have Kofax RPA registered. Then you can go to downloads, and you can go to the latest version of Kofax RPA, 11.1. You can go there. Proceed to download, and download the latest installer for Kofax RPA for Linux. There you go. It's going to take a while. So while you're doing that, you can get your hands on, indeed, Docker Desktop. You can just download it from here. And again, I'm going to put all of these links in the description below. I like to get the Windows terminal, which you can actually download from either from GitHub if you want, or you can download it from the Microsoft Store, whichever you prefer, of course. And you also need to have a good text editor. So I like Visual Studio Code. There it is. And the reason why I like Visual Studio Code is it does a lot of the Docker highlighting extremely well. And yeah. Once you've got all of this up and running, you'll be ready to go. So once you've finished downloading Kofax RPA for Linux, you've installed Docker Desktop, and you've made your choices regarding terminal clients and text editors, we can actually, well, dive into the actual bits and pieces. But before we do that, I do want to address the elephant in the room here, and that's all people that are thinking, well, Jesper, why are we using Kofax RPA for Linux? Why not use the Windows packages? Well, the reason for that is quite practical, and that is that Windows containers tend to be significantly bigger than Linux ones. And even though I've got a pretty beefy laptop here at my disposal with 2 terabytes of storage, I still like my containers to be as lean and mean as possible. So both Kofax RPA for Windows and for Linux can be used to build containers, and both of them will work just as fine, but this is the main difference. So that being said, it's up to you to decide whether you want to do the Linux or the Windows ones, but they do have some differences in how you need to deploy them. But the actual documentation is extremely extensive on both those parts. So for the rest of the video, I'll be doing the Linux ones, but feel free to follow along for Windows. So that being said, let's have a look at what we just downloaded. And you can see that we now have a .tar.gz file that we've downloaded from delivery.colfax.com. And we can then use capabilities like 7-zip or other unzip applications to extract all the information from there. But as we need to get comfortable with the command line anyway, well, let's just start with that, shall we? So what you can do is you can just right click the folder where you've downloaded it to and open a Windows terminal straight there. If you just have PowerShell installed, hold your shift key down and then right click and you'll have the open PowerShell window option there as well. I'm going to use Windows Terminal as said before. So here we can now use the tar command, which is fully incorporated into Windows, and we do dash X because we want to extract it with F for the actual file, and you can just go to the file with tab and you'll find it. Press enter, and you'll need to wait a while for everything to be, well, unpacked, so to say. So it typically just takes maybe 30 seconds to unpack that. And what you'll already see is that if you open up the folder that you just extracted, there is already a Docker folder in there that has all of the Docker files and all of the compose examples there that we can use to build our solutions on top of. So let's have a look at these compose files and have a look at what Docker files actually are. So in the folder compose examples, you'll find several example configurations that you can use. For this first part, I'm just gonna grab the basic one and I'm gonna put that in the root of the Colfax RPA folder that we have. And I'll tell you why later on. So if I then open that up with code, you'll see that we have several pieces that actually make up a solution. So we have a network and we then have a collection of services, and we have a database service, we have a management console service, and we have a robo server service. And this is essentially the, well, the simplest Colfax RPA implementation there is, of course. Just robo server, management console, that's it. So if we then open up the Docker file for instance, the management console, you'll see that the management console has a very different role to play. This is essentially the instructions that are read to actually start building those images. So it's gonna grab the base image that contains Tomcat, and it's then just gonna install the management console on top of that. And that's about it. You can, of course, make changes to this. So what I typically do is I also include the JDBC driver for Microsoft SQL server databases. And you can just add that reference there and that's it. For those of you who are interested, I did put a lot of these images already on a Docker container, on a Docker repository, namely the Docker Hub, and I'll put the link in the description below. I will be talking about Docker repositories in a later video, but for now it might be good for you to know that we already have some there, not officially condoned by Colfax, just me doing that. But if you want to have a look, please do so. And then those Docker files are of course referenced in the compose file. So that's why we had to copy that compose file to the root of the Colfax RPA folder, because then you have the right context to get to Docker Management Console Docker file. So you can see that we have a reference to that Docker file for both the robo server and for the management console, but not for the MySQL database. And again, that's because that's going to be downloaded from a Docker repository. Again, here the Docker Hub. And you can, of course, also make some changes here to the environment settings. So one of the most common uses here is, of course, to put the license information already here in here for the management console. So we just grab the license that we got when we requested the trial. So I just put that in. So I have a non-production key there. I don't have a production key, and we need to include the information for the company itself. Oh, there we go. So what I then like to do is I just copy and paste that on all three of these places. Because we don't have a production key, we won't have a production cluster, so we have to tell the robo server to announce itself to the non-production cluster. So there you have it. All of the other configuration is of course part of the example that we have there. So we can make changes to, for instance, the MySQL root passwords, but that's all self-explanatory. So I'm expecting that you will be able to figure that out. So let's just save that. And what we then need to do is if we go to the root, you have that new version right there. What we can then do is if we rename that to just have Docker Compose, then the Docker Compose command will automatically recognize that. So that being said, let's have a look and get to the command line again. And we can just say, well, I am in the right location, Docker Compose, YouTube demo. And we're going to say, well, we want to bring this up and we want to detach that. There we go. So this is going to take a while. So I'm going to speed this up in the video. And once this is done, we'll have a up and running Kofax RPA environment. Intermission. So we have created the images and we have spun up containers. So now we can actually test it and we can just have a look at the localhost, because that's where everything is running. Localhost, like that. I'll put http://in front of it. There you go. Here we go. We can immediately log in with the standard password. And now the next thing to check is, of course, if we also have the Robo server up and running. There you go. So what did we see in this longer video than expected? We introduce some of the key concepts behind Docker, so containerization, separation, but also that universal fit. And we talked about how you can then get a hold of Kofax RPA, what are the tools that you will need going forward, and we showed you how you can easily spin up Kofax RPA environment with Docker. There's going to be a lot more content following on this in the rest of this series. Please let me know if you have any feedback. And for now, I would say thanks a million. Talk to you again soon. Cheers.